Welcome to Crescent. In this training module, we'll learn about operating the Norfolk Southern Electromotive GP38-2, the 16-cylinder, 2,000 horsepower, 4-axle BB GP38-2 has proven successful in many roles, from yard switching to mainline hauling. It can lay claim to being one of North American railroading's most successful and versatile road switchers of the past 5 decades. Almost all trains on the Horseshoe curve route use lash-ups of multiple locomotives on the head end. We must set up the diesels accordingly as lead and trailing units. Let's start by climbing. Any trailing locomotive must have its control stand disabled so that it can receive commands from the lead unit. The units must also have their brakes set to cut out and trail. This is our lead locomotive, in other words, the unit we'll be operating from. We must thus switch on its controls. Our two units are now ready to operate. Insert the reverser, set it forward, release the brakes, and apply some throttle. Then proceed to the destination marker and stop there. The path to your destination has been set for you in this scenario. Please be aware that there are numerous manual switches on the Horseshoe Curve route, particularly in the yards and on the South Fork branch, and the engine crew must always ensure the switches ahead are aligned properly for their movements. Thank you. Welcome to Altoona. This is the famous Juniata Works. In this training module, we'll learn about operating the Norfolk Southern General Electric ES-44AC. The General Electric ES-44AC 12-cylinder form generates 4,400 horsepower. Is simply put, the dominant North American diesel locomotive of recent decades. Almost all trains on the Horseshoe curve route use lash-ups of multiple locomotives on the head end. We must set up the diesels accordingly, as lead and trailing units. Let's start by climbing aboard the trailing unit. Any trailing locomotive must have its control stand disabled so that it can receive commands from the lead unit. The unit must also have their brakes set to cut out and trail. This is our lead locomotive. In other words, the unit we'll be operating from. We must thus switch on its controls. Our locomotive controls are now active. Next, we need to set the brakes for lead and cut in, which we can do on any one of the two screens located on the control desks. Our two units are now ready to operate. Insert the reverser, set it to forward, release the brakes, and apply some throttle. Then proceed to the destination marker and stop there. The path to your destination has been set for you in this scenario. Please be aware that there are numerous manual switches on the Horseshoe curve route, particularly in the yards and on the South Fork branch, and the engine crew must always ensure the switches ahead are aligned properly for their movements.
Thank you. Thank you. Hey there, folks. Welcome to another Friday Simple. First things first. And I am going to be using the rail driver for its work, or at least trying to. First things first. So we've got several units on the head end and some DPUs to the power on the ass end. You're going to want to put your banking comm, which is kind of a cheap way of getting that started. So before you do anything, it would seem you're going to want to hit that right away. Any kind of helper or trail operation. So I'm going to go ahead and pop that on and turn enough boards on. Make sure it's in run. Yes, it is. I'm not going to worry about the safety systems right now. The only thing that really works, as far as I know, is the alerter. Sadly, I don't think you have signaling works. I'm pretty sure it doesn't. Pop the lights on. Click that gen field switch. Go ahead and put the reverser in here. Gauge lights on. Step lights off. Alright, and let's get going. I believe, nope, that is not it. We need to set this thing up here. So we're going to go ahead and get the air brake set up. Set this up to lead. So we're going to cut it in. Set it to lead. Save it. And exit. Alright, so we'll go ahead and throw a port. Give it one notch. I believe this little bit right here, when you start down at the south end of the South Fork branch, which is what we're on again, you kind of head downhill for a second here. So I got one notch on it. I got the independent brake fully on, and I'm going to release the train brake. We're going to let it build, which they changed it. There was conflicting reports of what was going on with this, the braking, because and then shooting that way, it's like we're pushing down. Go. And yeah, it's almost a mile long. 0.8. We're going to go ahead and scooch it on up.